I'm the scholar. I'm Lily. And I'm going to be giving you my perspective and my point of view on the London and Wales study abroad. So, I noticed a variety of things, so this video may be a little all over the place, because I tried to view it from a more artistic standpoint, an open-minded standpoint. So I noticed things such as the architecture in the buildings, the clothing of the people, and how people socialized and how they talked and how open people were and weren't between here, London, and Wales. How accessible things were, how walkable the cities are, how different the nightlife is, and the cleanliness of the cities. So yeah, I'm going to be focusing on all those, and I'm going to be popping up throughout the video, rocking the FCJ merch, just giving you a little bit more analysis of the videos that I've taken, and I hope that you enjoy. Thank you very much. First things that we notice is just how walkable the space is. The second we get off the plane, we jump straight onto the tube, and it's my first instance with public transportation like that, because living in Florida, there's not much of that, and I've never been to New York, so it was really fun to experience that, and we just continue to experience that throughout the trip. We use the tube, we use the double-decker buses, we just use normal buses. Like, public transportation is key. And another thing that we noticed is the architecture. Like, in a previous clip, you could see the Shake Shack was an old building that was transformed into a restaurant, and we saw that with a bunch of places. We saw that with a Five Guys, McDonald's, there was an M&M shop, which was interesting. So the city ended up having that old kind of gothic architecture going on, even with modern establishments like that, which is very fascinating to see. So I thought that was really cool. That was one of my favorite things about it, was the walkability of the area, and that stayed. Even now I miss it, thinking back on it, just how easy it was to get from place to place. Here, it's 30 minutes just to get from the home to school, at least, not even accounting for traffic. There, we could get from where we were to Camden to Soho in 30 minutes and be back with plenty of energy to spend.
What was your opinion about the double-decker bus?
It was really cool.
Ivory, come here. Ivory, what was your opinion on the double-decker bus?
Let me get a picture.
I cannot believe that.
So, our third day we spent touring Westminster Abbey and Parliament. I know the majority of us, when we left Westminster Abbey, the church specifically, we were just fascinated by the architecture. There was just, like, gold intricate everywhere, there was mosaics, there were tombs and memorials dedicated to people, so there was, like, Stephen Hawking, Isaac Newton, all kinds of people dedicated in this space, as well as, you know, the past queens. And funny enough, we visited these areas on King Charles III, the current monarch's birthday. Which is fascinating, which means there was a lot of people there. We also got to see the ins and outs of Parliament, which I didn't get much footage of, but we got to see the difference between the House of Commons and the House of Lords and walk our way through them with a guided tour, which was really cool, especially comparing the differences between, you know, the US's government versus the UK's. So the UK is really interdependent with these houses, while the US, we kind of rely on the separation there. But we left that place with a lot of knowledge on the UK's government and the UK's churches and how they function, which was awesome.
sneezed.
Oh my, Caleb, we gotta say.
I love the Welsh.
Drew, what do we have to say? We're in Wales.
This is very, very cool.
It's beautiful.
My sunglasses broke.
I'm actually just gonna move
that. You heard it here, folks. It's a peak. Was the National Library of Wales, which I thoroughly enjoyed. We were actually given a tour on the archives and where they store their books and how they keep them particularly monitored so that things don't get damaged and that things don't get burnt up in case of a fire with CO2 sensors. I believe they said there was 7 million items in there and counting. Plus, the life in Wales compared to London is vastly different. London was a lot more lively, there were a lot more people out late. There were always people out and walking it because it's such a big city with so many businesses and so many establishments to stop at. Meanwhile, Wales, you know, we're in Aberystwyth. This is a small town by the beach. So I know our first night we spent there, I actually went walking and the city was just barren at night. It was kind of eerie. But during the daytime, it's lively and it's beautiful and I actually love the place. I always thought I'd be a big city gal, but Aberystwyth has kind of changed that for me. About it. Thank you.